Mike mentioned FedEx. FedEx has traded 7 million shares. It's up almost 15 bucks. Normally trades 2.8 million shares. It's up over 100% for the year. Royal Caribbean is through the roof. Foot Locker had a bang-up earnings report. That stock's up over 20%. Even Boeing is on the move here. Wynn Casinos, Dave & Buster's. You know, these are names that have just been watching. But what's crazy to me is that they're moving like tech stocks. You know, in other words, investors are saying, okay, we're going to take a break on all these big names that we know, but they're powering these names higher at the same sort of rate that we saw tech stocks go. I mean, are you okay with that?
Yeah, I don't even really find it that surprising, because we've been talking about this for the last several months, that these tech names are just getting more and more expensive, but it's really purely based off people willing to pay a higher price for it. It's not as much just their earnings going up. At a certain point, you're going to see that reverse. And there's a lot of names right now that are still undervalued and so much cash on the sidelines, and you're going to see people start to draw this back in. And it's actually very similar to what we saw in April, where the coronavirus cases started to level off. We immediately saw things kind of reverse back to those cyclicals. And right now, we're actually a few weeks after kind of a peak of cases and starting to see things reverse back to cyclicals. And I think you'll continue to see this trend continue as those mega caps are just getting that much more expensive.
I want to ask you all your thoughts about where Congress should be with respect to more stimulus and what it would mean for the markets, Courtney.
Yeah, any stimulus we're going to get right now is a benefit. And realistically, it's the consumer that's driving the economy right now. And the consumer's actually in a pretty good standpoint. They have been saving more right now. Credit card debt has come down by 12% just over the last couple of months here. And there's still a lot of cash on the sidelines that people can bridge this gap and just kind of get them through as to things get back to normal. And any stimulus is only going to make that more attractive. So I think we're really going to continue to hopefully see that consumer spending boost. And that is going to help the economy. It's going to help the stock markets. It's only going to be an added benefit as we look forward.
Twitter, guys, we know it's in the news big time today. This morning, in fact, they opened nicely on talks that they're in talks with TikTok. The company would, of course, need a partner or would have to raise cash to make it a buyer. What's the best fit for TikTok? Would it be a Twitter? Would it be Microsoft?
I think the most realistic option is going to be Microsoft. They're a lot further ahead in a deal right now. Realistically, they have the cash to back it. I mean, we look at Twitter, and they just recently became profitable in the last year or so, but they actually did just post a loss again. They'll have to borrow the money to do this. So I think realistically, we're probably looking at Microsoft.